Hello students, we are going to study Hansenberg's uncertainty principle. Hansenberg said that for microscopic bodies it is impossible to determine the position and velocity simultaneously at a particular time with absolute certainty. Okay, here for microscopic bodies it can be done. Simultaneously velocity as well as position can be determined at a particular time with absolute certainty. Okay, but it is not the case with the microscopic bodies. Okay, he gave a mathematical expression for his theory. He said that how it is written, change in position into change in momentum is greater than or equal to h upon 4 pi. Okay, it can also be written as change in position into mass change in velocity is greater than or equal to what, h upon 4 pi. Okay, likewise it can also be expressed as change in position into change in velocity is greater than or equal to h upon 4 pi, what, m we have kept over here, h 4 pi m. Okay, now why does this uncertainty occurs? Actually it occurs due to the dual nature of the radiation. Okay, so let us see the verification of uncertainty principle. How can it be verified that yes, the position and the velocity cannot be determined simultaneously at a particular time with absolute certainty? Okay, so here you can see this is a microscopic body. Okay, in order to see the position of this microscopic body, what happens, it is needed to incident a photon of small wavelength, then only this position of this microscopic body can be seen. Okay, and from where it is seen, from the microscope. Okay, so initially this microscopic body was having this position. Okay, and it is seen from the microscope from here, and a wavelength of incident photon is very very small, and we are need in order to see the position only the small wavelength has been used for the incident photon. So what happens when small wavelength the photon of small wavelength is incident, what happens in on this microscopic body, the position can be seen. But what happens, as the wavelength of this incident photon is too small, it has got tremendous amount of energy, and this disturbs the the velocity of this particle, and as the result now it moves on, takes a new path. Okay, here if we are taking the incident photon of greater wavelength, then the position can't be seen, or it cannot be made out with certain absolute certainty. Okay, but yes, the velocity can be found out with total certainty. But here we are seeing this in this case of microscopic body, this position and velocity cannot be determined simultaneously with certain with the absolute what, certainty. Okay, now here this striking photon okay makes a large difference in the position and velocity of this particle, microscopic particle like electron. Okay, here when it strikes this electron, both the position and the velocity is disturbed a lot, and as the result what happens, this electron gets what, displaced to a very greater extent, and as the result its position and momentum cannot be determined simultaneously. So we have seen that yes, what, the position and velocity cannot be determined simultaneously in case of microscopic objects, isn't it? If we are talking about the electron, what happens if the wavelength of light, a certain wavelength of light is incident on that electron, what happens? It goes to, it displaces a lot and it goes to what? Unpredictable what? Position. Okay, so now, so here Hansenberg uncertainty principle is applicable for motion of microscopic object and is negligible for what? The macroscopic objects, isn't it? Here we are studying about this only from the initials only, that it is not applicable for the microscopic objects. It is applicable only for what? The microscopic objects. Okay, so how can it be verified? Suppose if a body of mass 1 milligram, 1 milligram is equal to 10 to the power minus 6 kg. Here we are applying the Hansenberg's principle. Okay, change in position into change in velocity is equal to what? Change of h upon 4 pi m. So here we are putting on the values. Planck's constant value is what? 6.626 into 10 to the power minus 34 kg meter square per second, isn't it? Now here 4 into pi, value of pi is how much? 3.4, isn't it? And mass, what it has been given? 10 to the power minus 6 kg. When you will be just substituting the values and you'll be getting the answer, that is 10 to the power minus 28 meter square per second. This is a very small quantity. Okay, and as it is a very small quantity, it can be what? Neglected. And as a result, this equation of this microscopic objects, when we put it in Hansenberg uncertainty principle formula, this is not applicable as the value is too small. Okay, but yes, when we are taking electron, okay, what is the mass of electron? 9.1 into 10 to the power minus 31 kg, isn't it? It's a very small value. Okay, so putting in the formula of Hansenberg, delta x into delta v, it means change in position into change in velocity is equal to h upon 4 pi m. Okay, putting the values of Planck's constant, 6.626 into 10 to the power minus 34 upon 4 into 3.14 into what is the mass of electron? 9.11 into 10 to the power minus 31 kg. Okay, now after solving this, we are getting how much? 10 to the power minus 4 meter square per second. If we are saying 10 to the power minus 4, it is not a small quantity, isn't it? It is quite big quantity and this cannot be negligible. So Hansenberg's uncertainty principle is applicable for the microscopic objects and is not applicable for the macroscopic objects, isn't it? Micro, it is applicable, MICRO, but for MACRO, macro, it is not applicable, and this can be verified in this manner. Okay, this is all for today. Good day. Take care.